How are you? Okay.
Bank.
Everybody says bank? Okay, so the answer is neither. They're the same.
Oh.
Exactly the same. $16 collection or $16,000 collection? Which is worse?
Bank.
Exactly the same. Depending on how old they are. Exactly the same. Credit card limit. If you have, you're trying to build credit, so your teenager, 18 years old, is trying to build credit, and is it better for him to open his own $300 credit card or get added to your $30,000 limit credit card? Which is going to build credit faster?
The $300?
Open
his own $300.
Okay, so let's say he opens both of those. He can get a $30,000 because it's Donald Trump. Which is going to build his credit? They're both just his or hers. They're both exactly the same. Down a few years ago, Credit Repair took off, and there's companies in California that you pay me $500 and I add you to a $50,000 credit card. I was selling sizzle. So instead of paying them $500, you could split up $300 and get your credit card and do the exact same thing, and they get your money back. This is a good one. Royal Furniture or Ashley Furniture? Which is better for your credit rating or worse? That seems like that would be the same, but actually, and I'll tell you why, Royal Furniture will kind of help your credit. Ashley Furniture is going to kill your credit.
Everybody
knows that. Finance company or bank loan? That kind of goes back to the department store or bank credit card. Finance company or bank loan?
The same.
Same? Bank loans better?
Yeah.
Bank loans much better. Finance company loans kill your credit. There's the reason. I don't know. I don't have a
question.
I'm telling you what's good for the credit score, not what's morally right or whatever. I tell my customers, if you want to pay this, why do you want to have that collection? I'll pay that tomorrow. No, if you're going to pay it, pay it after you get in the house. Credit cards, has anybody ever heard if they have a ton of unused credit cards, you should close it? There's a reason we learned that, and that came from like our grandparents. But most of the time, you never want to close your credit cards. You want to keep them active. So at least use them once every 6 months to keep them active. I'm going to get into my letter. Do you already know the perfect number of credit cards to have? How many?
All of them?
One.
Those are very good guesses.
One.
It doesn't matter. There's a perfect number. The perfect number is 3 to 5. So I tell everybody 4. So if you're new, teenager, trying to establish, you don't want to go out and open 4. It just takes time. You just want to open 1. But if you're 46 years old and you're competitive and you want to have an 820, 4 credit cards, 2 department stores, 2 banks, only carry a balance on 1 bank, 1 department store at a time. There are 96 factors that go into your credit score, of which only 6 are positive and help your score, and most of those revolve around credit cards. That's what you're seeing. Most things can only, out of those 94 factors, can only hurt your score. For example, a late test. Okay, this is some facts. You ready? Are you ready? Credit scores. Break them down into 2 parts. There's everything on your credit score and credit card. Credit cards outweigh everything. Everything else is nothing. I'm going to talk about everything else first. So everything on your credit report has a set amount of weight. The amount of weight it has is 100% based on how old it is. So if I'm late on a car payment last month and you're late 4 years ago, we're exactly the same. We've both been late one time. But time heals all. You haven't been late in 4 years. Your credit score is a lot higher than mine because I was late last month. So it weighs more. Same offense, collection, dollar amounts don't matter. It's time. So basically, everything in the last 12 months has 100% strength. So if you were late last month, something bad happened in the last 12 months, I said if you ever pay a collection over 12 months old, your score will always drop. So in year 2, it drops to 60% strength. Year 3, 30, year 4, 10%. Anything over 4 years old basically weighs nothing. 0 to 5%. So once you visualize this, the clothesline. If you put 100-pound weight on the clothesline, it's going to pull it to the ground. That's your credit score. If something bad today pulls the score way down. Over time, the quilt dries or whatever, you put a sock on it, it barely pulls it down. So why we don't pay those collections? If it's over 3 years old, it's a 10-pound weight, and your score is down to 6-8. If you pay it, you renew it. It goes by daylight activity. If you pay it, you renew it, it becomes brand new. It goes to 100 pounds, and now it's going to report for another 7 full years, and you got to go through this process all over. So, if you have a loved one who's being collected, you pretty much never want to pay the collection. Some only have to get mortgages, but in general, a $10 Comcast collection, they don't want to pay it.
Hey,
it's going to drop her score. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
And that was fast. So I'm taking the reason, I asked you 300,000 or 30 and all that stuff. But the FICO score, 94 factors can never look at dollar amounts. If it did, it would discriminate against the rich or poor. So Donald Trump's got a $30 million credit card, and I've got a 300. His score shouldn't go up any faster than mine because it's relative to our income and lifestyle. box and the sale at Dillard's, you're at 100%. So your score is based on this number. You control LeBron James. If he's playing for you, playing against you, or doing nothing. So you control it by what balance you have. Does anybody want to take a stab at the right balance? Zero? How much?
25%.
25%? This is for somebody building credit. 25 and zero?
Max it out.
Some people believe max it out. Some people, there's a big theory up there, max it out, because I want to show that I can handle the debt. So all I can get is $1,000 credit card. I owe $1,000. I make my payment every month. I'm showing the bank, the lender, that I'm responsible. Some people say 50% or 70. The actual answer, because I've got to quit, I can't play a lot of games with you, 7%. 7% of the limit. Down to a $300 limit. Once you get down to $300, you just want to charge $11 to $12. So if your teenager opens a secured credit card, it's either going to be $300. Let them carry a balance of $11 to $12. That can, a $12 balance on a credit card can increase somebody's score over 250 points in 30 days. I've done it. Can't do it for everybody. No, there's a reason why. But that's how powerful it is. I've helped people come into my office, they want to buy a house, they have one example, one collection, and it was an old medical, it had nothing positive. So I told them exactly what to do, open a credit card, charge $12, 45 days later, we're going to Royal Furniture, get an installment loan, and then in 6 months, you'll be over 720. In 6 months, you'll be 728, you're still in that house, and you're sending me a referral. Credit card. So 7%, so basically, how can I have 10 minutes open? I'm going to stop. So the questions that I asked in the beginning, I'm going to stay after. I love credit scores. I'll stay after and answer anything you got. I'll explain. I'll ask Carrie to do this.
Which one quick question? We were talking about
I have a question. You said for the $300 limit, carry $12. Carry as in carried over, let interest get on it.
$12, your minimum payment is going to be $12.
Okay, and pay it off each month.
Pay it off and you'll charge $12.